Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Content Marketing Handbook, How to Double the Results of Your Marketing Campaigns, by Robert W. Bly, narrated by Barry Abrams. Preface. Of the mega trends in marketing today, which include search engine optimization, SEO, online video, social media, mobile marketing, ad retargeting, and infographics, content marketing is emerging as the new killer app in the marketing world. Although content marketing has been used profitably for more than a century, its popularity has exploded in the past couple of decades. According to the Content Marketing Institute, CMI, as of 2017, almost 9 out of 10 B2B companies were using content marketing. The CMI also says corporations spend more than one quarter of their promotional budgets on content marketing. According to market research company Forrester, in 2016, U.S. businesses spent a total of $10 billion on content marketing. Content marketing was forecast to be a $300 billion industry in 2019. Yet many content strategists and advocates get one part of marketing entirely wrong. They tell unsuspecting business people that it is no longer effective to sell or persuade, and instead advise them to think of themselves as publishers instead of marketers. The error in this method, of course, is that businesses exist to sell customers products and services they want and need, and for which they will pay a price that allows the seller to make a profit. Business's purpose is not to give away free information, which is essentially what content marketing is. Content marketing is not an end unto itself. It is a means to an end, to sell products. Content is not the be-all and end-all of marketing either. It's just one of many methods that can be used to get customers, orders, and sales. Content marketing is most effective when it's integrated with a multi-channel campaign that not only educates consumers with content, but also offers that content with various direct response methods, both online and offline, to generate leads, prospects, and sales. This is the approach you will hear about in this book. In this handbook, I share lessons from my four decades of experience planning and producing hundreds of content marketing campaigns. In this book, you will discover why content marketing is so effective and economical, which types of businesses and organizations can benefit most from content marketing campaigns, how to create A-level content that gets noticed, gets read, gets your message across, and eliminates content pollution, how to overcome the biggest weaknesses of content marketing, how to double your marketing response rates with lead magnets, bonus reports, and other free content offers, how to integrate content and direct response marketing to produce greater results than either can generate on their own, how to use content to build your brand, enhance your reputation, and stand out from your competitors, how to plan, execute, and measure content marketing in a multi-channel environment, when to stop giving away content, the easy part of marketing, and start asking for the order, where the money is made. Tip: URLs change all the time, which means many URLs in published works quickly become outdated and non-functional. To keep the Content Marketing Handbook as up-to-date as possible, I periodically send the new URLs to my readers. To get them at no charge, just subscribe to my free online newsletter, the Direct Response Letter, bly.com/reports/. Another way to find the updated URL is to Google the source by name or even by the old URL. My aim is to show you content's true role in integrated multi-channel marketing campaigns. This book can help you avoid wasting time and money by giving away content with no return on investment, and instead create and offer content that can build trust, stimulate interest, and ultimately get more orders, in a way that creates a stronger relationship with your buyers and helps them get maximum benefit from their purchase of your products. Introduction: Content Marketing in the 21st Century. Content marketing giving away free information to build brand awareness, increase response to marketing campaigns, convert more online traffic, and educate prospects on your technology, methodology, products, services, and applications is one of the hot trends in marketing today. Other marketing methods currently popular include online video, social media, QR codes, search engine optimization, SEO, live online chat, mobile marketing, and infographics. But, as the saying goes, content is king. More than 8 out of 20 e-commerce shoppers conduct online searches before they make a purchase, and 7 out of 10 cite detailed product content as the number one reason they buy one product over another. Brands that submit content for SEO can boost their sales more than 25% than retailers who just advertise. Origins of new terms are often murky. Content marketing may have been coined in 1996 at a roundtable for journalists held at the American Society of News Editors by John F. Oppedal. In fact, content marketing has been used for far longer than that. It's only the name that is of recent vintage, not the method. I personally have been doing content marketing for 4 decades, and some marketers have been at it even longer. Online marketing expert Fred Gleick calls it edutainment, because the content ideally should be educational and entertaining. Today, more attention than ever is being focused on content as a marketing tool. For instance, in August 2017, Apple announced the company was making a $1 billion investment in original content for its Apple TV platform. By 2019, a report in the Financial Times estimated Apple's content investment at $6 billion. In 2019, Forrester forecasted that by 2023, annual digital marketing dollars spent by businesses will reach $146 billion. The average American spends almost 9 hours a day engaging with digital content, while millennials spend even more, 11 hours. No wonder 53% of marketers consider articles and blog posts their most used technique for inbound marketing. I did my first content marketing campaign in 1980. I was advertising manager of Koch Engineering, an industrial manufacturer run by the late David Koch, who at the time was the Libertarian Party's nominee for Vice President of the United States, back when he was relatively unknown. Later, of course, he became a household name as half of the infamous billionaire Koch brothers. One of the products we sold were various tower internals, and one type was the tray, circular metal discs with capped openings on their surfaces. The trays were placed inside refinery towers to enhance the distillation of crude oil into kerosene, gasoline, heating oil, jet fuel, and other petroleum-based products. Specifying the correct configuration of trays for your refinery is a highly technical task, and the engineers in the refineries often needed instructions for how to do it correctly. To assist them, we produced a technical manual that we dubbed the Tray Manual, which cost several dollars per copy to print and bind. It had stiff covers, a spiral binding, and fold-out blueprint drawings showing the configurations of various trays. The Tray Manual was not my idea. It was already in use when I joined the firm. It was wildly popular, by far our most requested piece of literature. Back then, we didn't call it content marketing. We called it giving away free information, but the practice was the same. Copywriter Bob Martell says he called it pre-sales educational writing, which, he notes, requires you to know something about both education and sales. Content marketing has been used for more than a century. To test responses to his print ads, Claude Hopkins offered free informational booklets in many of his ads. And in 1916, Campbell's began promoting its soups with content marketing by offering free booklets of recipes that used Campbell's soups. Back in those days, this free content was simply called free booklets or free information. In the latter part of the 20th century, marketers referred to them as bait pieces because they helped hook prospects and turn them into leads. Today, the preferred term for free content is lead magnet, the idea being that the tempting offer of valuable free information is like a magnet that draws people into your ad and gets them to request the white paper or other free content. A content offer with multiple components, such as a product sample, brochure, and DVD, is called an information kit. There are all sorts of opinions and tests on the effectiveness of content marketing, but let me sum up my experience in just two simple points. First, I can't remember the last time I did a B2B, business-to-business, or B2C, business-to-consumer marketing campaign without a free content offer. For B2B, the lead magnet is often the primary offer that drives prospects to respond. For B2C, it is often a bonus report given along with their purchase of the product. Second, adding a lead magnet to a B2B lead generation campaign can often double or more the number of inquiries instead of the same campaign without the free content offer. In the good old days of B2B marketing, our primary offer was a free color brochure filled with sales copy about the product. It worked then, but today, prospects respond better if you also promise to send them free how-to information, such as a special report or white paper, which will be useful to them in their job, rather than just selling them something. Customers want to get something from their content, and the statistics agree. For instance, 80% of Americans prefer a series of articles over an ad. 70% say content marketing makes them feel closer to a product or business. 60% credit content marketing for helping them make better purchase decisions. Content marketing costs 62% less than outbound marketing and generates 3 times as many leads. 90% of the most successful B2B content marketers put their audience's information need over the company's sales and promotional messages. Although a large number of B2B companies use content marketing, it is not in everyone's wheelhouse, and it may not be ideal for you. But if you want to gain content marketing skills, knowledge, and results, this book is a good place to start. 3 of the top 6 challenges in B2B content marketing revolve around producing content. Chapters 2 and 3 address this challenge, and chapters 5 through 14 give detailed instructions for implementing it. Measuring content effectiveness and ROI is covered in chapters 16 and 17. Budget is discussed in Chapter 3, which is about planning your content marketing campaigns. All the top challenges for B2B content marketers, which I believe apply equally to consumer marketing, are covered in this book. Let's get started. Part 1. The Foundations of Content Marketing. Chapter 1. Setting Yourself Up for Content Marketing Success. What is content marketing? Simply put, content marketing is any marketing activity that helps sell a product, service, or organization with the offer of free information. Content marketing is a powerful way to engage your industry, generate leads, and close deals. Marketers in countless industries are now creating valuable content for their prospective and current customers. You can do the same with content. Here are some examples. A social media post talking about attending a business conference, a trade journal article on industry trends, a recorded webinar with valuable information about specific technology, a blog post with tips on tackling a new challenge, a white paper explaining an important concept in your application or niche market, an e-newsletter with tips and reminders. The following lists some of the more popular formats for content marketing. Content formats: tip sheets, how-to sheets, booklet, article, e-newsletter, column, monograph, mini report, case study, mobile apps, white paper, slide guide, selection guide, DVDs, CDs, webinar, teleseminar, flashcard, software, games, ebook, print newsletter, use cases, applications, streaming video files, online audio files, paper-bound books. As you can tell from this list, content marketing is not just another term for ads for your products. Instead, it provides valuable how-to or reference information to prospective or current customers. Content marketing educates your customers to help them do their job better and faster. But the content, naturally and sometimes subtly, influences them to favor your methodology, your brand, and your products. Content writing and copywriting. The power of your content lies in the writing. Content does not explicitly sell your product, but rather helps sell it indirectly by educating your prospect. Sims, a New Jersey-based clothing retailer, ran radio commercials in the 1980s with the slogan, "An educated consumer is the best customer." That is content marketing in a nutshell. By educating prospects on your methodology or technology, you increase, for reasons you'll discover later in this book, the chances they will buy from you instead of your competitors. But it's a soft sell. You are giving them information to help them do a task better, rather than blatantly selling your product or brand. Copy is text about a specific product or brand that openly sells the product to customers. Content achieves a number of objectives, including building brand awareness, educating the marketplace, establishing you as the go-to source of information on your topic, boosting search engine rankings, spreading ideas, changing beliefs, presenting a methodology or idea for solving a problem, and persuading people to agree with your point of view. Direct response copywriting, whether digital or print, is much more narrowly focused. The prime objective here is generating and improving response, including increasing open rates, click-through rates, conversion rates, list building, generating leads, qualifying prospects, selling products and services, and cross-selling and updating buyers on your other products. Where content sets the stage and warms up prospects to accept your offer, it is copy that closes the deal and makes the sale. Order pages, for example, are usually copy, not content. In addition, offering content as a lead magnet virtually always increases response rates to direct response promotions, including email and direct mail. So the two go hand in hand. Direct response copy is used in email, direct mail, and advertising to direct traffic to websites, landing pages, and squeeze pages. These pages, in turn, use direct response copy to convert the clicks into either leads or sales. Generating inquiries for lead magnets also helps distribute your content to a larger audience. Here is a simple sales funnel for integrating direct response copy with content, in which direct response copy is used in promotions that drive traffic. Example, an email that convinces the recipient to click on a hyperlink for more information. Content is used in the lead magnet, which the email copy offers to the user. Direct response copy is used on the landing page, which converts visitors who land on the page by persuading them to complete and submit the landing page form to download the lead magnet. When visitors download the lead magnet, it captures the prospect's name and email address, generates a lead, and helps distribute the content in the lead magnet to a wider audience. The 7 fundamentals of good content writing. If you asked me to name the 2 biggest trends in B2B marketing today, I'd have to say social media and content marketing. And social media seems to work best when it's based on content. But content marketing isn't just publishing information. There's way too much information available today. Your prospects are drowning in it. What they are starved for is knowledge. They want to know how to solve problems and how to do their jobs better. The following list walks you through 7 guidelines that can help set up your content marketing campaign and make it more productive and effective. Tip: you're not in business to publish free content. You're in business to sell your products and services. Unless publishing content helps you achieve that goal, it's a waste of your time and money. 1. Narrow the topic. There is no benefit to cramming every last bit of information about a subject into your white paper or other content marketing piece. The prospect can easily find that data through Google. content marketing works best when you narrow the topic. The more precise the topic, the more in-depth and useful your content can be. For instance, let's say you are an industrial gas manufacturer creating a 10-page white paper on safety for plant managers. If your title is Plant Safety, you cannot hope to cover that topic in even the most superficial way. Entire books have been written on that subject. On the other hand, you could produce a very useful white paper called Safety Tips for Handling Compressed Gas Cylinders. That's a topic plant personnel want and need to know more about. And with your experience, you can probably offer some methods that are new to the reader. 2. Target the prospect. The more narrowly you target the audience for your content marketing piece, the better able you are to deliver truly useful content. For our example of the white paper on compressed gas cylinders, are you targeting plant managers or plant operators? Managers might be more interested in cylinder inventory and control, whereas operators would want nuts and bolts tips for handling the cylinders. A CFO would want to look at reducing costly gas cylinder accidents, while a CEO might be more concerned about liability. 3. Determine the objective. Remember, you're not giving away information out of the kindness of your heart. There has to be a purpose for the content you spend time and money to produce. For instance, a software publisher discovered that it wasn't losing sales to a competitor because their products had better features and benefits. It was because the software in that category was expensive. And even though the prospect wanted the functionality the software delivered, they couldn't cost-justify the purchase. To solve this problem, the company published a white paper called Calculating Return on Investment for Purchase of XYZ Software. It showed that the time and labor savings the software provided could pay back its high cost in 6 to 8 months. Salespeople then used the white paper to overcome the objection that it cost too much. 4. Educate the reader. Years ago, Duncan Hines ran an ad in magazines about its chocolate cake mix. The headline was, "The Secret to Moister, Richer Chocolate Cake." Why was that headline so effective? Because it implied you would learn something useful just by reading the ad, regardless of whether you bought the product. Generic advice won't cut it in content marketing today. The prospect does not want to read the same old tips they've seen a dozen times before. Chances are, you possess proprietary knowledge about your products and their applications. Share some of this knowledge in your white paper. Give your readers specific advice and ideas they haven't seen before. Don't worry that by giving away too much, you'll eliminate the prospect's need for your product or service. It's quite the opposite. When they learn how much effort solving their problem entails and see that you clearly have the expertise they need, they will turn to you for help. 5. Deliver value. When you can, include some highly practical, actionable tips the prospect can implement immediately. The more valuable your content is to prospects, the faster your content marketing program will achieve its objective. It's like food vendors giving away samples. The better the free food tastes, the more likely the consumer is to purchase a snack or a meal. 6. Set the specs. Outline the characteristics, features, and specifications the prospect should look for when shopping for products in your category. Of course, the requirements you outline should fit your product to a T. If you do this credibly, the prospect will turn your white paper into a shopping list. 7. Generate action or change belief. Content marketing succeeds when it gets prospects to take action or change their opinion, attitude, or beliefs about you and your product as it relates to their needs. When writing white papers, I always ask my clients, "What do you want to happen after the prospect finishes reading our white paper?" I often end the white paper with a section titled, "The Next Step," which tells the reader what to do and how to do it. Writing technical content. A lot of B2B marketing either promotes technical products, sells to a technical audience, or both. The nature of these marketing campaigns poses a challenge to those who must create them, because the marketers tasked with executing these campaigns often lack a technical background. Therefore, they may have a steep learning curve and difficulty understanding what they are selling and to whom they are selling it. I have been writing copy to sell technical products to engineers, scientists, programmers, and other techies for more than 4 decades. Here are 7 tricks of the trade that give me an edge in creating copy that pleases the client and persuades the prospect. 1. Build an accurate fact bank. A fact bank is a series of statements describing the product and its features that have been vetted by a technical expert. Before I start writing my copy, I go through the source material for the project and write down 5 to 10 sentences that precisely describe the product, how it works, its major features, and how those features translate into important benefits. I email these sentences to my clients with the request that they review them and make any necessary corrections, additions, or deletions. After they do so, I incorporate their edits. Now I have a set of pre-approved sentences I can use to construct my copy, and I know what I am writing is technically accurate. The clients then get a first draft of copy on a highly technical subject that is correct and on the mark. 2. Buy a children's book on the topic. If you have to write copy about a technical subject, buy either a children's book on the subject or an adult nonfiction book aimed at a lay audience. For example, when I had to write copy for an aerospace contractor, I was aided by an Isaac Asimov book for young readers about satellites. The children's books especially will provide clear, easy-to-understand explanations of key terms and concepts. The adult books will likely have descriptions of features and functionality you can paraphrase in your own copy. If I borrow from books, I alert the client by adding a footnote and make sure I am not plagiarizing by rephrasing in my own words. Another good purchase for the high-tech copywriter is a dictionary of industry terms. I have owned, at various times, dictionaries for computers, telecom, banking, finance, and aerospace. 3. Ask the client for copies of PowerPoints. Engineers in particular tend to be visually oriented, so you should have visuals to accompany your text. Rather than draw a lot of charts and graphs, I ask the client for copies of PowerPoints used in presentations by their technical and sales staff. I then paste into my copy whatever visuals I think will work best, carefully noting the name of the PowerPoint and the page number from the source. Sometimes I find an ideal diagram for illustrating my point on a website that is not the client's. If I use it, I add a note explaining that it is for reference only and must be redrawn to avoid copyright infringement. 4. Understand that graphics have meaning. Unless you understand what a chart or graph means, don't use it. It is extremely embarrassing to cut and paste a diagram from a client's PowerPoint into your copy, only to be unable to explain to the client why you used it. You should understand each visual so well that you can write a clear, descriptive caption for it, and then do so. 5. Use email for interviews. I often interview subject matter experts, SMEs, when writing copy over the phone, but occasionally I get SMEs who cannot express themselves well verbally. In those cases, I offer to email them questions so they can email me their replies. Often, technical people who cannot speak English well can still write decently, perhaps a result of the rise of email, which forces people to write often. At times, the email replies are so clear that I can almost paste them right into my copy. If the answers are still unclear, I rewrite them in plain English and then email my rewrite back to the SME for review. Usually the SME makes a few minor edits, and after that, it is ready to use. 6. Use Wikipedia with caution. You can't wholly rely on information in Wikipedia to be accurate because it is compiled by volunteers. However, I've found that entries on technical terms usually start off with a plain English definition of the term, which can be invaluable. But when you are researching statistics to augment your copy, for example, the date the laser was invented or the speed of sound in a vacuum, most clients want a better source than Wikipedia. Websites are also iffy when you don't know who is running them, as are blogs. I prefer to cite an article in a respected industry or scientific journal. 7. Get smart. If you are going to be regularly writing about a product or technology, it makes sense to get some additional education on the topic. One ad agency president told me he assigned an account executive to handle an industrial welding account. On his own, the account executive took night school courses in welding, eventually becoming a certified welder. Smart move. The 9 functions of content marketing. Content marketing performs 9 functions that help B2B as well as B2C marketers generate more leads and ultimately close more sales. Let's explore them. 1. Sets the specs. As mentioned earlier, content marketing can educate prospects on what features, functions, and capabilities they should look for when buying a particular type of product or service. Because you have presented your criteria in a white paper or other medium that looks like useful information and not a sales pitch, readers absorb and accept your guidelines. Then they use the specifications you have set. Say you sell motionless mixers, one of the products I help market at Koch Engineering. You offer in your ads a booklet called 7 Things to Look For When Specifying Motionless Mixers. Prospects read it and use your criteria when looking to purchase motionless mixers. And whose mixer fits all 7 criteria perfectly? Yours. 2. Makes the prospect beholden. This is the principle of reciprocity, as described by marketing expert Robert Cialdini in his book, Influence, The Psychology of Persuasion. When you give somebody something, they feel obligated to give you something in return. Giving a prospect free content does not make them feel obligated to buy your product, but it does make them inclined to give you a little more of their time and attention than they otherwise might. More than half of buyers strongly agree that if brands packaged relevant content together, it would help expedite the research phase of the buying cycle. Content marketing includes delivering personalized, segmented, and relevant content to your existing customers. By keeping your current customers engaged and updated with great content, you'll improve your long-term customer retention rates. Richie M., one of my newsletter subscribers, told me in an email, "This is just a short note to say that I really enjoy your emails. I can tell when they are commercials, but don't mind them, because you generally also give me worthwhile information. I believe that is why you are successful. When I receive useful information in free emails, I am more likely to purchase additional information, and I have." Richie's response is what you hope for when writing content. 3. Generates more inquiries. A lead-generating promotion with a free content offer can produce more than double the response as the same campaign without the free offer. Good content marketing is that effective. By publishing new and relevant content on your digital channels, and doing so often, you can increase the likelihood of new customers finding out about your business, its services, and the value you can bring them. Plus, prospects are more likely to return to your website when they know you frequently add fresh content. 4. Gets you new customers. Many marketers acquire new customers through their blogs. Whether your content first caught a prospect's eye on Google or a white paper they downloaded on your site tipped them over the edge, content marketing plays an important role in the B2B purchase lifecycle. Typically, a B2B prospect searching for a product may work through 70 to 90% of the product search, research, and evaluation process before contacting the vendor, according to Forrester Research. B2B vendor research happens online, and one thing that can help move the prospect down the pipeline is publishing valuable content on your website, email, search, and social channels. For emails sent regularly to your opt-in e-list, half or more of the messages should be content, while fewer than half should be sales emails. If you send too many sales pitches and not enough good content, your unsubscribe rate will spike. So will your mental unsubscribe rate, meaning that although people won't ask to be removed from your list, they just stop reading or even opening your emails. 5. Establishes you as the expert. Publishing content on your industry, niche, or area of specialization helps position you as a recognized authority in your field, and prospects would rather buy from knowledgeable experts than ordinary salespeople. Charging your organization with regularly creating new content fosters a culture of research, innovation, and thought leadership. In a rapidly changing industry, content marketing can help force your team to stay up to date on changes and trends, which can become invaluable in your product development efforts. It should not be solely the marketing team's job to generate all the material used in your content marketing efforts. Account managers, SMEs, and even long-term clients and site visitors can be engaged to help create great content. 6. Educates the market. Content marketing supports your sales efforts, but its first mission is to educate and inform, not make blatant product pitches. 9 out of 10 of the top-performing B2B content marketers put their audience's informational needs ahead of their company's sales message, reports the Content Marketing Institute. One marketer of content management software, CMS, was the first to integrate their CMS with analytics, e-commerce, and other applications. But the market did not yet understand the benefits of this integration, so the marketer published a white paper explaining them, with good results. 7. Drives sales. Content can be strategically disseminated at various steps in the buying cycle, helping to accelerate each step and ultimately increasing sales. The sales funnel takes most buyers through 4 stages: getting their attention, gaining their interest, creating desire for the product, and asking for the order. Each stage can use both selling, copy, and education, content. 8. Improves search engine ranking and discovery. Search engines love new, relevant, indexed content. When you host your content on your website, whether through blog posts, white papers, or web copy, you can improve your search engine ranking and the likelihood customers will find your website. According to accounting firm Ignite Spot, a blog on your website will lead to 434% more indexed pages on Google and 97% more inbound links. By increasing your indexed pages and links, you'll make your site more reputable in a search engine's eyes. Higher search engine rankings mean interested prospects are more likely to discover your site when they search for relevant keywords. 9. Drives web traffic. Search engine discovery combined with social posts that point to your site can increase your web traffic considerably. According to HubSpot, if you've got 51 to 100 pages on your website, consider each blog post to be a unique page, you'll generate 48% more traffic than if you had under 50. Increased traffic means increased engagement, means increased revenue. Content and the Silver Rule of Marketing. My friend, the late consultant Pete Silver, formulated what he called the Silver Rule of Marketing. It is always better to get them, prospects, to come to you than to have you go to them. That's really what these 9 functions of content marketing are all about. I urge you to practice this silver rule. When you go to prospective customers, you convey the impression of needing the sale. When they come to you, they are more qualified. People like to buy from companies they perceive as successful and busy, not those that seem hungry for orders. Cold calling doesn't do this. Content marketing does. Establish yourself as a recognized expert by giving seminars and speeches, writing articles for publications read by potential clients, or writing books. When you get an inquiry from someone who subscribes to your e-newsletter, you are negotiating from a position of strength because they came to you rather than you calling them. When someone approaches you at a conference, says they loved your speech, and asks about engaging your firm's services, you are in a position of strength because they approached you in response to the good content you just delivered. Why does Tom Peters get $30,000 or so to give a 1-hour speech on business and have more business than he can handle, while other speakers struggle to get bookings for $2,000 or less. It is largely because, as a best-selling author, he is perceived as an expert, and so prospects come to him rather than him going to them. He has become a successful marketing consultant simply by practicing the silver rule. You can too. In addition, almost 50% of business people use content marketing in their follow-up to event attendees, and 2 in 3 of these say this strategy is highly effective in continuing the conversation and leading to new business. The 10 steps to building a successful content marketing campaign. What makes for a successful B2B and B2C lead-generating content marketing campaign? There are 10 key steps. 1. Define the target audience and their information needs. 2. Come up with a strategic or useful content plan. 3. Select a format or medium for your lead magnet. 4. Create a great title for your lead magnet. 5. Research, organize, and write the content. 6. Create a landing page for downloading the lead magnet. 7. Drive traffic to your landing page. 8. Fulfill inquiries. 9. Follow up. 10. Secure an appointment or conversation. Let's briefly touch on each of these 10 steps. If you follow these steps in order and execute each skillfully, you will greatly improve your odds of having a successful and profitable content marketing campaign. Step 1. Define the target audience and their information needs. In B2B, defining the target audience or readership involves knowing the industry, company size, and prospect's title, responsibilities, education, and degree of knowledge in your chosen topic, as well as how they use your type of product in their business. You should also think about the information needs of prospects at the stage of the buying process at which you are reaching them. In the initial search for solutions, or the shopping stage, the prospects for the content management software mentioned earlier needed to understand the unique selling proposition, USP, of the system, the integrated analytics, and the benefits it could deliver. The marketer successfully educated prospects on this front, but when buyers evaluated economic considerations, they felt the high-end CMS was too expensive. They liked the features and what the system could do for them, but they didn't see how they could justify spending that much money. In fact, a good CMS can quickly pay for itself, so the system was really a profit center, not a cost center. But prospects did not see this. The solution was for the marketer to publish another white paper. This one showed prospects how to calculate the payback period for investing in the CMS, which was in the range of 6 to 12 months. Doing so overcame the price objections for a lot of buyers. Step 2. Come up with a strategic or useful content plan. A strategic content plan is one in which publishing and distributing the content solves a marketing problem. In our example of the CMS marketer, both white papers were strategic. The first solved the problem of prospects not understanding the benefits of the integrated analytics. The second solved the problem of sticker shock, prospects objecting to the high price. A useful content plan is disseminating information that is of value to the prospect in their job, but is not a sales pitch for your product or service. For instance, a computer reseller might offer prospects and clients a special report on how to prevent data loss or avoid hackers, malware, and viruses. This kind of actionable information doesn't specifically accelerate the steps in the sales cycle or sell the prospect on the reseller or its solutions, but the prospect will appreciate the free tips, and they will reciprocate by viewing the reseller in a more favorable light. It builds goodwill and creates the impression that you are an expert in your field. Step 3. Select a format or medium for your lead magnet. For a long time, the de facto standard in lead magnets for selling hardware and software to IT professionals and executives was the white paper, a downloadable PDF document averaging 10 pages in length. but content can be presented in many other formats and media, and your choice can make a big difference in the success of your content marketing campaign. One effective alternative to white papers is a physical paper-bound book. The problem with PDFs is that it is so easy to click away from them. Also, prospects are inundated with white paper offers, so yours won't stand out. When you mail prospects a real book, they take notice. Books also have a higher perceived value than white papers. And while downloaded PDFs can sit invisibly on hard drives, books are right there in plain view, sitting on a nightstand or on a shelf in the office. There are many other options available to you for lead magnets. You can offer a free webinar, online course, podcast, infographic, or poster. Post a video on your site or YouTube. Send an audio CD or a DVD. Load useful data and content onto a thumb drive. The key is to think beyond a downloadable report or white paper. Yes, they are effective, but alternative media, because they are less common, often gain more attention. Short ebooks. One of the most interesting lead magnet formats I've seen in recent years is the extremely short book, both in print and ebook form. Short format books have fewer pages and often a smaller page size. Full size and short format books address different purposes. Where an audience is large and content is both broad and deep, long form books provide these high value functions: exploration of multiple concepts, case studies, credibility, supporting documentation. A book with the full story plays a large role in building credibility and authority on an entire body of knowledge or area of expertise. But the best book is not necessarily the most inclusive. If you're trying to show your reader how to look at a specific issue in their life or business with an altered perspective, a full-size book could be too intimidating. Many readers just want to learn the basics in as little time as possible. If they remain engaged, they'll investigate further for more specifics. All you really need to do is build a bridge to your platform. This is where books, training, websites, and/or webinars serve as revenue streams and additional ways for people to connect with you. Short-format books are optimal as an opening connection to your audience. They serve to deliver the essential aha moment that binds them to you or convey that essential knowledge they seek to enhance their skill set. When your topic is timely but your message timeless, a short book is ideal. The small size and page count makes the short-form book unusual and therefore a real attention-getter. Also, the text is far shorter than a conventional book, so less writing is required, and it's cheaper and easier to produce and distribute. You can easily carry paper-bound little books in your bag or pocket and pull one out to read when waiting at the bus stop or bank. It's even more convenient for readers who prefer ebooks, as it can be read with less scrolling. Plus, it can be given away as lead gen or sold for a small price on online retailer sites. With short-format books, you can attain instant credibility. When you hand someone a little book, you gain the authority of being an author without having to write a full-length book. The book you are reading now is about 80,000 words. The average short-format book is under 10,000 words. Step 4. Create a great title for your lead magnet. Perhaps the biggest factor determining whether prospects will request your free content is the title of your lead magnet. The title is like the headline of an ad or the subject line of an email. In fact, it often is the headline or the subject line. The purpose is the same: to grab the prospect's attention, generate interest and curiosity, and compel them to request the lead magnet. To do that, a great title must stand out, identify the subject of the paper, and suggest who the target audience is. Type of title: list. Example: the top 7 security problems of 802.11 wireless networks. Type of title: action verb, ing. Example: managing large Unix data centers. Type of title. Why? Example. Why Six Sigma doesn't work. Type of title. Colon. Example. Defending the remote office, colon, which VPN technology is best? Type of title. How to? Example. How to prevent machine parts from failing prematurely? Type of title. Dramatic. Example. The death of passwords. Step 5. Research, organize, and write the content. The amount of research you need to do depends on your knowledge of the topic, but even if you know the topic well, do some outside research. Start with searching Google for any white papers on the same topic by competitors. Subscribe to e-newsletters on your topic and read trade journals covering your industry. You want to augment your knowledge of the subject with facts, figures, and ideas outside your own. Whenever you use data, graphs, or other content from outside sources, credit the source in a footnote. Once you've gathered your content, think about how to organize and present the material. Sometimes the content naturally dictates a particular organizational scheme. For instance, if you were writing a guide to vitamins, you might use alphabetical order. Tip: the cover of the lead magnet should have the title in large type in high contrast, such as big, bold, black type on a white background. This way, when the cover image is reduced to fit in an email or landing page, the title is still easily readable. Avoid color schemes like dark blue type on a black background, which may make the title difficult to read. A booklet on the solar system might cover the planets in order from the closest to the sun moving outward. A history of the semiconductor could be approached in chronological order. At other times, no organizational scheme seems mandatory or apparent, and it is up to you to select a sensible way to organize your material. Something as simple as a numbered list might do. These are called listicles. Or you might choose a Q&A format, as in an FAQ page on a website. Now that you have your content and a way to organize it, write your document. Start by placing your content and research under the appropriate chapter or section headings. Next, turn the raw material into clear, concise sentences and paragraphs. Remember that small words, short sentences, and short paragraphs make for easy reading. Do not avoid simple writing because you are talking to an educated or technical audience. In 4 decades of writing for engineers, programmers, scientists, and executives, I have never had someone complain that a document was too easy to read. Tip: you can either post your landing page on a URL that is an extension of your main domain name, bly.com/dm, or a unique domain name, myveryfirstbook.com. The former adds content to your main site, which helps with SEO, but the latter is easier to remember, which is especially useful when you are giving a talk or want to recall the URL when speaking to prospects. Once the document is done, edit to make it tighter, clearer, and better. Remove redundant sentences. Cut unnecessary words. Divide long sentences into 2 or more shorter sentences, starting the new sentence where a new thought begins. After you are done, give your document to a professional proofreader. Because you have already read the text many times in the writing process, you cannot trust yourself to do the final proofreading, as you will gloss over the copy and miss typos and other errors. Step 6. Create a landing page for downloading the lead magnet. A common mistake in content marketing is driving traffic to your website's homepage and hoping visitors can find the box or link needed to request the lead magnet. Chances are good they will not. In addition, your homepage has lots of options for navigation, so when visitors get there, they will start clicking around and either forget about or never find your free content offer. A landing page is a standalone web page where the prospect can request the free bait piece or lead magnet. On a properly designed, effective landing page, there are only 2 choices: request the free lead magnet or leave. Therefore, the conversion rate, the percentage of visitors who fill in and submit your form is much higher on dedicated landing pages than on home pages or any other web pages. That there are three options in the landing page: get the free lead magnet, receive information on the product or service being promoted, or have a salesperson contact the prospect. Also notice that whichever option the visitor chooses, you capture their name and email address. Therefore, in addition to generating qualified leads, this landing page also helps build your opt-in email list. The visitor can choose one, two, or all three. Those who request product information or a call by a salesperson are generally better prospects than those who ask for the lead magnet only. Having said that, there will be visitors who want only the lead magnet, but upon follow-up, convert into buyers. So don't discount or neglect them. Step 7. Drive traffic to your landing page. The success of your content management campaign depends on two factors: traffic and conversion. Traffic is the number of people who visit the landing page. Conversion is the percentage of those visitors who fill in and submit the form. How do you drive traffic to your site without burning through your available cash in a couple of weeks? Here are 7 cost-effective ways to get hits on your site. 1. Google. The world's largest search engine, Google facilitates 3.5 billion web searches per day for its users. As an advertiser, you can buy higher rankings in Google's search engine based on keywords on a cost-per-click basis. It could cost you as little as a dime a click or more than a dollar a click, depending on the popularity of the keywords you want to buy. If the cost of a keyword is 30 cents per click, and 100 people click on your site that day as a result of a Google search on the keyword you bought, Google charges you $30. You can limit how much you spend per day, so the cost can fit any budget. 2. Affiliate marketing. Find websites that cater to the same market you do and arrange for them to feature your products on their site and in their emails. Online ads, email blurbs, and web pages talking about your product linked to your site, where the user can purchase the product. In return, the affiliate receives a percentage of the sale.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.